I build strong relationships. I build strong personal relationships and create Fusion family members for life. There you go. All right, number three.
Number four.
That is number three. Okay, number four is we prioritize an excellent outcome over a flawless process. It's never gonna be pretty, but it doesn't matter as long as we get that shit done.
Prioritize excellent outcomes over a flawless process. It's not always going to be easy, but we don't care as long as we get the job done. We are dedicated to our goal and flexible in our approach. Business is a war we compete for every day and battle and take ground from our competitors. I create work environment of teamwork and synergy. I'll skip this one.
you skipped one.
Which one? Don't, it was six. Just give me the six.
Half the business is
one. I forgot the six. What's the first one? It's okay. Give me the first one.
I don't know. Nobody knows.
I have all of you guys.
You weren't supposed to, though. That's the thing. It's like.
I own an immediately so guess problem. I listen with intent to understand, not just respond. I create work environment of teamwork and synergy. I cheat. I don't conflict the moment with the progress. And number eight. Look at what won't happen, that's not good.
No, you got it.
You're
on the same.
I know that it was.
You see it?
I cheat. I told you guys. Give me the first word. You guys didn't want
to
give me
one. We're all here.
You got the rest of them.
I know there is no such a thing as failure if I take every opportunity and learn and grow from it. I'm the reason we succeed. I don't count the hours. I make the hours count. 11. Feel passion. I remember the things I said, I'm still on fire, feel my passion to do the things, and I wake up every day and go after it. I'm responsible, uncompromising levels, service and cleanliness, second to none. Being the best is not for everyone, but that's what we signed up for. That's it.
Cool. Failed too.
Alright, so everybody helps.
Not a hater.
I feel like you're waiting for people to fail.
So let me ask you this. If I ask you to say it again in 20 minutes, are you going to say it flawlessly? The answer is no.
I didn't say it flawlessly the first time.
It doesn't matter.
So it's knowing it and then
so
knowing
this is,
it
this
so
is
well.
Where you guys are getting confused. You guys are memorizing it like if it's a test and not memorizing it like it's going to be a part of you.
This is part of my life. That's why I'm good, but I think it is.
You can tell you tried.
But
I'm saying you haven't tried.
So like, when I'm saying you don't know it, it's because you actually don't know it. You can say that you know it, but you really don't. Because anytime you would be asked, you should be able to just spit them all. Then you can say you know. You can say number seven, and you should say it without hesitating, without stuttering. If you ask for number two, you should be able to say it without stuttering or even thinking about it because you know it. It's part of you. So we study it not to get it right, but to never get it wrong. So we're treating it like if it's a test. Because after, like, we're just studying it just to say it now and then not say it again tomorrow or the next day. We need to learn it so that you don't forget it, where you can just spit fire whenever you want. So you guys gotta stop treating it like it's a test. I mean, I have no excuse. I don't know them all. I know the first six. I learned them all yesterday. I didn't have the time for it. I just changed that. I didn't put the time for it, which is a bad example. But I will learn it, but I'm not gonna just learn it so I can stand up and say it one time. I'm gonna learn it where I can say it anytime. Someone calls me, I can spit it. Tony just pulls me to the side, I can spit it. Anybody asks me, I'm gonna be able to spit it. That's the difference between learning it and just memorizing it to just say it during a meeting. And if I learn 6 in one day, you can learn all 12 in a week.
Read the little one yesterday.
Not if you have brain.
So when you say know it, can somebody memorize it in a week? Yeah, but you're talking about know it backwards and forward. You call
it number. Put the time for it, yeah.
I think he wants us to memorize.
He's supposed to know
all of it, like we know number one.
He's supposed to memorize. He's supposed to know it.
Like we know number one.
He's supposed to know it. He wants it known backwards, forward. You can say it from 12 to 1, 6 to 12, and then 5 to 1, however it is. But he wants them all to be known. It's not just study it just so we can say it one time during the meeting. We're supposed to learn it and live by it. That's the whole goal of learning the principles. We're supposed to learn it.
So you know number 9 just as well as you know number 1.
Yeah. Alright, well, since everyone went, I don't know the moment, but I'll say the first 6 for the best of my ability. I started studying yesterday around, what time was that, Kev?
4 o'clock.
Like 4 o'clock? Yeah, it was definitely a long night. And I woke up earlier to try to study just so I can say as much as I can about it. First one, I embrace change as a core of our business. It's the only thing that is consistent. We either rise or fall and we can float. Number 2 is we maintain an offensive mindset at all times.
It's that word.
It is that word. I'm always waiting for an answer. I'm always responsive to the expressed and the non-expressed wishes and needs of our family members. That's the full thing for number 2, right?
Yes.
Alright, number 3 is I am empowered to creating unique, memorable, and personal experiences with our team and our members. And after that, that's definitely not all of it. There's one more line after that. That's all of it?
No.
No, there is more? I build strong relationships. I build strong personal relationships and create Fusion family members for life. There you go. Alright, number 3.
Number 4.
That is number 3. Okay, number 4 is we prioritize an excellent outcome over a flawless process. It's never gonna be pretty, but it doesn't matter as long as we get that shit done.
Yeah.
And the line after that is we are dedicated to the goal but flexible with your approach. Number 5 is business is war. We come ready each day for battle, or we come ready for battle each day and take ground from the competitors. That's 6. Number 7 is
business is
5. What was number 6? Did I skip 4?
No, number 5 was more.
6. I'm not gonna ask for the first word. It definitely would help, but I'm not gonna ask for it.
Hi.
That's a letter.
Jersey. New Jersey? South Jersey?
South Jersey? We don't have the keys yet. Still waiting on that. So, not sure.
Macy's.
We're still waiting on the engineer drawings to submit to the township.
Yeah, he just did another rough draft, and he just came to Macy's the other day.
Like Tony does, and talking about, oh, come to the best fucking gym in the world. Now you see the doing that. He never came on camera. He was never on Instagram. He was never on Facebook. None of these gym owners were on Facebook talking all this shit until Tony and fucking Fusion were doing it. Now that Fusion's doing it and people are seeing the results of what Tony and all of us did in the beginning, Saturday, it's fucking packed. We were dead on Saturdays 9 months ago, 10 months ago. Now, even our Saturdays are packed. Our events are going fucking wild. You know, you don't see this at any other gym. The other gyms are just, they're popular because they offer like these family packs, but that's only for families. What about the people who don't have families? What about the people who don't celebrate Thanksgiving? You know, so it's like, this is the first time where it's like, it's starting to make that turn of people talking shit to the positivity. Like everybody I see now, they're not talking shit. They're like, oh, you work at Fusion Gym, that's fucking amazing. It's not, oh, you work at Fusion Gym, you must be laundering money too. Like, then no, that's not how it works. Like, look at all the people that fucking come here now. This Saturday's never looked like this. You got the barber shop has nonstop people on fucking weekends. You got the two barbers that work on Sundays because of how busy they are during the week. You got people coming in the Fusion Fresh nonstop now. So it's like, the turn is here. Like, the time is here. Like, for Fusion to like, we made the flip. Now we just prove to everybody why they're coming here. So like, we convinced everyone to be here. Let's prove to them why they're gonna stay here now. That's the big thing for me. Is like, I'm from this fucking area. We have nothing besides like St. Mike's Fair to look forward to around here. I look forward to coming here all the fucking time, even if it's just for Fusion Fresh or just to get a haircut. It's like just to see you guys or bother you. You know. So it's awesome. It's nice to see something in our town finally making that dent. Like, oh fuck, all these other companies now have to step up because of this place. We have a $350 million renovation going on for one of the biggest schools in the county called Pennsbury. All right, we have four clubs. Pennsbury. Pennsbury. Pennsbury High School is one of the biggest high schools in this area. They're doing a $350 million renovation to their school, which is going to raise all of the house values and all the business values around here drastically over the next period, 5 years. By 2029, they're going to finish that renovation. So like this whole thing, all that renovation is going to do is attract more money and more people. And those people aren't going to want to go to the YMCA. They're going to want to come here. They're not going to want to go all the way to Newtown when their school's all the way down here. They're going to want to come here. They're not going to go to Retro Fitness or Planet Fitness or any of those $10 a month gyms because they're going to see this gym. This gym speaks for itself. It sells itself.
Happy belated, bro. Happy belated birthday.
Thank you.
How old are you?
15.
Old as fuck.
I'm 22.
What y'all gonna say?
I don't know.
When I say what y'all gonna say?
I don't know.
Can someone tell me what we gonna say?